places I can reach. You know that I can use somebody. You know that I can use somebody. Someone like you and all you know and how you speak.
Welcome to the Freeman Show. I'm with number one fitness model. I mean, this guy's got massive accolades and he was an inspiration when I was starting out training, looking at him in the front cover of magazines. Greg Plitt, how you doing, buddy?
I'm good, man. Pleasure to be here.
Pleasure. Thank you. Well, we're from America here at the Body Power Show. How was the event?
I've never been in a situation where, first of all, first time in UK, first time here, would not be my last. The people here are so genuine and so hospitable. I feel so welcome. I feel like I'm back home almost. You know, everyone's so nice. I was at the in line for some food, and there's this big, massive guy in front of me, right? Yeah. And they're messing up his meal, and the guy's like not getting irritated. Like even when they're mad, you guys are polite. I love it. And he's like, and they fixed him, and he's like, cheers, bloody thank you. And I'm like, God, this guy's like the size of four men, and he's just so polite in his anger. I'm like, this is just a cool town, man.
In the States,
people
are more on the edge.
They give you the finger more often than not, you know? And they kind of have an attitude. But so it's a breath of fresh air, and it's been a real honor being here.
Yeah, it was a great event,
and you know, it's definitely grown over the years, it sounds like. So hopefully, looking to come back next year.
What kind of advice would you give anybody who's kind of plateauing in the results?
Yeah.
Because everyone plateaus in their training, everybody. So what would you do to change it up?
Sure.
And you're very versatile in your physique. You're agile, you're fast, you've got the muscle mass as well, and you stay lean, but it's not just about like basic bodybuilding. There's a lot more to you.
There is, you know, and I think the gym is a metaphor in life. Mm-hmm. I mean, the gym is where you go in there and you hone fundamental blocks of character. Those characters, blocks are like dedication, due diligence, sacrifice, work ethic.
Exactly.
You learn them in a non-subjective environment. The gym, no one can give it to you or take it away. It's yours to earn. So you get up at 5 a.m. when it's raining outside, and you commit to something. You go in there, and over time, step by step, you start to transform yourself physically, right? And that's great. But that's not the greatest part. The greatest part is the hidden muscle, the biggest muscle in the body you use to transform, is your mindset.
Right.
You build a confidence that, you know, with hard work and dedication, those fundamental blocks, I can go from point A to point B and transform myself. That's a key lesson, because you can take that lesson outside of the gym and apply it to every theater of life.
Yeah.
To go from mailroom to CEO, to be a better husband, a better father, to be a better member of the community, someone that doesn't speak hollow words, but backs them up with action.
And it can serve and stand up and man up to responsibilities.
Exactly.
And that whole thing is like self-efficacy, right? You're building an inner self-belief and you're increasing that self-efficacy. I can do this.
You can, right. You start to believe in yourself and you start to turn your dreams into a reality. And when you're saying you plateau off, you're going to plateau off. Again, the gym is such a metaphor for life. You're going to plateau off in life over and over again. You'll hit those walls of adversity, but you're going to remember back in your time in the gym that you overcame adversity through just the marathon of life. You know, working out, it's not a sprint, it's a marathon. There's no short-term solution to long-term problems. So these plateaus in life, right? If your motivation is only about the vanity of what that mirror says, the physique, so try to get some sex appeal or something like that, that's not enough fuel in the tank to run the whole race,
right?
So what you do, how do you break that up? Because your body's always smarter than you think it is. Mm-hmm. They'll find an easier way to do the same workout more efficiently. That's good for the body, bad for your end state results. So you need to force your body to shock your system, forced to adapt to new situations. That's the growth.
Right.
So when you go to the gym, you start doing your conventional lifts, your bench presses, and your curls, and everything else.
The basics.
And then your body starts to grow, but then it gets used to that, starts plateauing off. So you always keep changing that up. But after a while, you can't change it up. So then you get out of the gym, and you start doing stuff like the CrossFit or strongman workouts, or start running hills, or bicycling, cycling. Start making the world your playground.
Right.
You know? And then all of a sudden, you really get hooked on what it's all about.
Mm-hmm.
It's not about just living, you know, looking good. It's about living life where you're not walking through it, you're running through it.
Right.
You know, or like there's nothing about you that's impossible. Everything's possible now because you believe in yourself, you know? And you learn all that in the gym, you know?
And that's where the character building is.
It's a character. It's a disease, basically. Mm-hmm. It's a positive disease, a positive cancer.
It's contagious.
Very contagious. Like, some people go to therapy for it, you know? Right. Some people do a line of coke for it.
Right.
I go to the gym for it. That's my fix. I need it.
That's your endorphin. That's what you're happy.
It's the same thing.
It's
endorphins released, you know? Yeah. And for a natural high. Mm-hmm. And that's success. And success is as addicting as any chemical drug out there. But the thing with success is, as you do it and you get more and more addicted to it, it's something that builds on you.
Right.
Instead of breaking down your foundation like drugs and all this other stuff does. So therefore, you start to believe in yourself. And then the sweat equity of life is it's a cornerstone, the foundation for every monumental task and achievement you're proud of for the rest of your life. Mm-hmm. I mean, the sweat and stuff, once it dries into the form of a legacy.
Right.
You know, that can pass on and help somebody else achieve their best. Now you got something special.
And now you're paying it forward and you're giving back.
That's what it's all about.
You're helping other people, which is part of who you are.
Yeah.
Everyone is part of who you are. You're in this time for a short period of time.
I made a website up because I got so tired of all the falsified information, all the products that weren't backed with research and stuff. And so I made up a website, breakplit.com, where I give the truth on everything. What I've done to, you know, be on a cover for the last 60 months straight, 5 years in a row.
Yeah.
You know, it's like, to do all this, how do you do it? Well, it's these principles and these principles. Above all, it's the mindset. You know, it's a mind-body connection, a natural high. And once you feel it, man, you just like, there's nothing you can't do.
I completely appreciate that. Yeah.
You know what I'm talking about?
You can do this, you can make it happen. You'll find a way. Yeah. You might not know how, but it'll come.
Yeah.
It'll just come in its
no doubt.
Forms.
No doubt, man.
But what got you, what was your catalyst to get you there in the first place? Was it family, was it friends, was it someone else?
I guess way back when, we can all go back in time. Everybody's different lifestyle.
Everyone has their own story.
But everybody back in life, you know, they had that moment where they failed, you know, when they're early on, the rejection. And they also had that moment where they succeeded. And they look back on that time and that feeling of emotion, the way you feel after failure, and the way you feel after succeeding, right? You felt them both.
Yeah.
Which one do you want? This one here, you can increase the odds of that occurring in success with hard work and sweat and dedication and sacrifice, and you can mitigate the risk, you know? Or you can give up on life and just live an average, nothing forgotten life.
Yeah.
Or you can be a life of legacy if you remember, you know, inspire people.
Right.
So I guess what started for me was this.
It's an expansion and growth. It's not only your banality.
Yeah.
It's adding more to who you are.
Yeah. There's something about like being like scared of something, having a fear and being fearful, right?
Right.
That fear is a self-created illusion.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
We can create that and we can destroy it.
For sure.
And when you have fear and you try something, you fail and you get knocked on your ass, right? And you find the intestinal fortitude to stand back up and face that same fear, stare back down the adversity and beat it back. It empowers you with something that no chemical drug can give you. It's something at high.
No one can take it away from you.
No, you earned that, you know?
Exactly.
And so when you taste that, you just want more of that.
Yeah.
So for me, earlier on, I tasted that, and I just wanted more of it.
It's almost giving you that rite of passage to build more of Greg Plitt's experiences of life and enjoying life.
True. I mean, I failed so many times, and I still fail every day.
Yeah.
But in my failure, I look at it as a positive. A failure is nothing but a report card of the current moment of where your strong links of life are and where your weak ones are. Knowing the difference, then you can apply your effort to the weak chain of your chain of life to improve the strength, you know? So without failure, we don't know where our weak links are. So maybe our effort's still always working to improve our strengths instead of our, you know? So people look at failure as a negative. It's not. It's a real positive.
Exactly.
You know?
Feedback.
That
is a great, insightful interview. I know he has a plane to catch.
Yeah.
I can sit here for hours and talking, but Greg, thank you.
Hey, my pleasure.
Thank you, man. Pleasure, my man. Thank you.
You're on.
Yeah.